Amen. We thank God for this is the last day of the year. Is that all y'all left for the last day? God has brought us from January 1st all the way to December 31st.
We lost a great one, Trustee George Hill.
day, I don't know if y'all watch BET and all that, and the BET war thing. Look at the ones that they lost throughout the year. We lost three this year. But guess what? God is still good. Even in the midst of heartache, God is still good. Even in the midst of emotional trouble, God is still good. He allowed us to see December 31st. He spared our lives one more time. And that's something we ought to be grateful for, amen? And then I didn't come to pump you up. I don't even really care if you pumped up or not. Because I am.
Yep.
What God has done throughout this year. I rejoice for what He's going to do. See, we got some sick folks in this church that have been sick all year long, been sick for several years. But as we're going into the new year, we're expecting a great miracle in the new year. Going into it in the new year with expectancy.
That's right. Yeah. Right. Yeah.
Not just the same thing as we did in 2023.
Yeah.
But we're going in with expectancy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Amen. I don't know what you're going to do. I'll tell you. I come to rejoice in the Lord.
Yeah.
For the great things He has done.
Yeah.
Amen. We're going to try to move on to the service.
Yeah.
And I'm not even going to read the scripture. I'm just going to quote it.
Uh-huh.
So it was in my daily reading on this morning.
Uh-huh.
And then following that, we're going to ask if Sister Dina Ross will give us our announcements. Then I'm going to ask Sister Taloya and Talisha will give us a selection.
Uh-huh.
Following which, we're going to have the Word of God coming from our bishop. Amen. We're going to try to get you out of here early so that you can come back on tonight. Amen.
Yeah.
But just because we're going to try to get you out of here early don't mean you let the fire go out. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Psalms 150 and verse 6.
All
right. You don't have to stand. You all know it. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hope you know how very much you appreciate it and what a difference you made. Joni Louie. And for our, see, the tickets will be going on sale January the 7th, 2024 for the banquet, and they are $35. All the members who signed up to go ahead and get those first, please try to go ahead and purchase them, because once we kind of put them to the public, they're going to be kind of going fast. So if you already signed the list, in advance, go ahead, we'll start January the 7th, and that's $35 again, and April the 7th will be the last day of 2024 to get the ticket, April the 7th of 2024. And for this evening, our watch night service, at 7 p.m., our minister, Barbara Craddock, will be speaking. Woo, and I believe that is all our announcements. Let's see, scripture for the month. Let's see. We need more time. I know the plans I have for you, but it's not for me. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. They give you hope and a future.
And a future.
When you seek him, seek him with all your heart.
Amen.
Jeremiah 29:9, verses 11, 12, 13. If you call these announcements of man, go to our service.
Amen.
Are you Lord God Almighty?
The preachers that are in the house, to the deacons, the deacons, If you want to visit, you welcome you to the house of grace. There are no one to start at the hand. Baptized Pentecost, the Church of Holies, we welcome you today. To you, membership, we honor you as well. God bless you. I want to thank God for all those who worked this year, preachers, deacons, deaconesses, musicians, choirs. God, I want to thank you for your service in this year, 2023. Thank you so much. Let you know that I do appreciate your service in this vineyard. God bless you. God bless you. I will not be here for you long. My sinuses are jacked up. And I'm going to do what I got to do. I'm sitting down. My sinuses are jacked up. It's messing with me at times, headaches, and all that stuff. But I'm going to do what I got to do and get out of the way. I have no intention seriously as God comes in real good. I have no intention.
He can do it.
I want to invite your attention to Hebrews chapter 13, verses 21. This afternoon, I'm going to read the New Living Translation. So I'll give a clear perspective on verse 21. And I'll be reading again from the New Living Translation of Hebrews chapter 13, verse 21. I'm going to turn on you just a little synopsis. But deal with this verse 21, supporting scriptures, and that's be it. Go to the center. Amen. Let's come in and we'll do what we said to do. You don't have it say, wait a minute. Okay. You have it say, words.
Word.
Thank you so much. You're so kind. For the New Living Translation of Hebrews chapter 13, verse 21 says this. May he equip you with all you need for doing his will. May he produce in you through the power of Jesus Christ every good thing that is pleasing to him. All glory to him forever and ever. Amen. You can see the rest of the world. Most gracious and all-wise fathers, thank you for your goodness, your kindness, and your tender mercy. And all of your bountiful, wondrous blessings you have stored upon us. And even when you have yet to do, we thank you. God, here again, I need you to be with me, speak to me, and speak through me. Send fresh manna from on high, open the ears of the hearers, the hearts of the receivers, that your word will fall on good and fertile ground, and produce fruit in days to come. God, I pray you keep me ever at the foot of the cross, where you can give a glory to honor and the life of me, your servant. Oh, God, let the words of my mouth, God, let the words of my mouth, God, let the words of my mouth be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer, these blessings I ask in Jesus' mighty and awesome name I pray. For your glorious son, Jesus, I pray and I do thank you. Amen, amen. Look at this verse again. May he equip you with all you need for doing his will. May he produce in you through the power of Jesus Christ everything that is pleasing to him. All glory to him forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
For the time we share together, my brothers and sisters, I'm going to talk from the subject of God equip me for your glory.
Yes.
God equip me for your glory.
Yes.
As we're in the last day of 2023 and we're going into 2024, the Lord's listening. The Lord has that delay is coming. We need to get equipped for 2024.
Amen.
We can't do the same stuff we did in 2023 and 2024. We can't have the same mindset we had in 2023 going into 2024.
Amen.
We must have a different mindset, a different perspective of our Christian walk with God. Let me go a little further, because our walk with God should be significant and serious. It should not be a haphazard walk. It should be a serious walk. It should be a jet propelling walk. It should be a walk where we desire more of Him, and that He be glorified and honored in the life of we, His people. The devil wants us to stay in 23. When we go, God blesses in 2024. He wants to stay in 2023. But if you want to be God's servants, and as God has called us to be, we got to look forward and forget about the past. Can I go a little further? Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
You remember in Genesis when God told Lot and his family, straightforward, don't look back. God did not tell Lot and the family that just to be sad. He said to say this: forget about all your past and look for the future. That is not in my notes. Thank you, Holy Ghost. He said, stop looking for the present and look for the future.
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
I don't want to be like I was in 2023. Dana, Sister Dana, quoted from the program, I know the plans I have for you. They're not a calamity and not a disaster. Watch it, but they are a future. Meaning that I don't want my people to stay in the same predicament and the same place they are in 2024. I want your whole mindset to change. I need your whole desire to change. I need your whole productivity to be better. Productivity, that's the word. Thank you, Lord. Be better. You cannot expect the same stuff in 2023 and 2024.
Amen.
Watch the test. He says, may He equip you with all you need for doing His will. This is the Apostle Paul telling the church in Hebrews. May He, God, equip you, provide you for what you need for going forward. I want to throw a question to us. Thank you, Lord. How hungry are you for a better future? How hungry are we for a better future? Raymond Third, there's a thing on my refrigerator that says this: if you keep doing what you're doing, you'll get what you always got. If you do what you're always doing, you'll get what you always got. Meaning that if you want to be better, do better, you got to plan for a future. And a better future than the present. May He provide you with what you need. May He prepare you for the future. It's a prayer, really. God, I need you to prepare me for the future, to be better, to do better, to think better, to act better, to behave better, have a better attitude going into 2024. Can I go further? God, take out all the toxicity out of my spiritual life, that I may grow and mature to be the servant you are calling for in these last and evil days. Supply you with what? Supply you with the resources you need.
Right. That's what you need.
Resources.
Thank you.
Those who are exclusive to listen to this, I think they have, I don't know if it's good or not, they have what is called a resource center. Okay, thank you. And in this resource center, you can go to this resource center and go and get what you need for what you have a need for. In this resource center, well, God has a resource center for us, and we got to go to the resource center to get what we need to be better and to do better. There cannot be a better and do better until we go to the resource center. That resource center is God and God Himself. You and I have to be hungry for the resources that God has provided for us. What are the resources? Then you ask me. The one of the resources is the Word of God. We sing a song. We used to sing a song. In the Word of God, I have a hiding place. The Word of God is to restore us, to revive us, to strengthen us, to build us up, and to change our lives for the betterment of God.
Yes, yes.
Resource. Are you going to the resource? Will you go to the resource center in 2024? Will you go to God and not go to people?
Yeah.
Hello. Yeah. Will you be misguided by going to some people who have not been to the resource center?
That's right. Yeah.
Watch this. He says, and also in the first portion of the text, he says, all you need. That word need is desirable. How desirable are you for receiving things from a resource center?
Yes.
How much do you desire a more of God? Now listen to me, I don't talk about the same. And I'm not saying about making a New Year's resolution, because we break them anyway. We break them in the next day. Stop doing that too. You do that, it's fine. Hello. I'm going to do better for God. Oh, just ask God to help me.
Yeah.
God, help me do better.
Yeah.
I'm not going to make a resolution, God, but I need your help to do better and to be better.
Yeah.
Watch this. This word will in the text means all you need for doing His will. We're doing His purpose.
Mm-hmm.
And His purpose, and not our purpose.
All right.
His purpose. His purpose for our life.
Yeah.
His purpose that we will be better and do better. The New King James says this. He says, make you complete. If you got a New King James version, that portion, he says, to make you complete. In this Greek, it's not a Greek word, rather, for perfect or perfection. Used throughout Hebrew to indicate salvation. But a word which is translated, prepare. It does not mean perfection. It does not mean perfect. But it means preparation. I want to throw a curve here, or just ask a question, brother. Are we making preparations for the Lord? Are we doing all we can do for the Lord?
Yeah.
Once this means prepared, it also means framed in. I'm framed in His will.
Yeah.
I'm framed in His purpose. I'm framed in His desire for my life. Not my desire for my life, but His desire for my life. I'm framed in. Watch this. It refers to a believer being edified.
Uh-huh.
I need to be built up. Come here, y'all. I don't know about y'all, I need to be built up every now and then.
Yeah.
Get go through the moments, go through the days, go through the times. I need God to edify me.
Yeah.
I need to build me up.
Yeah.
The weak spiritually, but I need Him to build me up.
All right.
Edify. Watch this. I love this part right here. The verb has an idea of equipping by means of adjustments. I need to adjust. I need to make some adjustments. I'm out of line. You know why your car gets out of line? Starts to shake. It needs an alignment. And we spiritually are out of alignment. And we need to be aligned and be adjusted by the resource of it. Not only do we need to be adjusted, but we need to be shaven. Not only that, we need to be mending and restored and prepared for His glory and His honor. Amen. The next portion of the text says this. May He produce in you through the power of Jesus Christ. May He bring forth in you through the power of Jesus Christ. I can't be brought forth until I have the power of Jesus Christ. I can't be brought forth in my own power, but I don't have much power. But Jesus has all power, and I can be brought forth in Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior. And so it means that I need to go to Him for more strength. I need to go to Him for more power. To be who He has ordained for me to be as a child of the Most High God. The next portion of the text says this. I like this too. In every good thing that is pleasing to Him, in every, it didn't say some things in the New Living Translation, it says in everything. Every good thing that is pleasing to Him. Can I ask you a question? Who are you pleasing? Who are, as we're going into 2024, who are you going to please in 2024? It says every good thing. Every good thing such as faith and faithfulness, obedience and perseverance. And He says, pleasing to Him to make Daddy God happy. Yeah. I don't know about y'all. Too much stuff going on.
Yeah.
Too many things are happening. Yeah. And they're happy quick, fast, and they're happy. I want to make Daddy God happy. Yeah. With my life, make Daddy God just be smiling on my life that is pleasing unto Him. Yeah. Watch this. Nobody else matters. It's God that matters. It's Him that my life is pleasing to. I gotta make Daddy God happy. If you don't like me or not, I'm making Daddy God happy. He's the one my life hinges on. My spiritual life hinges on pleasing God and God alone. If I please man, I should not be a servant of Jesus Christ. Hello. I'm in Bible country. Watch this as I come home. He said this. He says, in the fourth portion of verse 21, He says, all glory to Him. Stop right there. That's it. He says, all glory to Him.
Yes.
Not to man. Not to Bishop Ross. Not to Pastor Ross. Not to an apostle or prophet or minister or evangelist. It's all glory to Him. The last time I checked, the Bible says that no flesh shall give any glory. No flesh. Nobody shall get any glory. Meaning that no one shall steal God's glory. Oh, thank you, Jesus. All glory to Him forever and ever. Amen. So be it.
now. Meaning that it's sealed with the amen from God. The approval from God. All glory goes to him. Him and him alone. I don't care what nobody's title is. They receive no glory. It's God that received the glory. Because I'm pushing it down. My voice is getting a little better too. Nobody gets the glory. It's God himself that gets the glory. God will not allow no flesh to get in the glory. He will not allow mankind to get in the glory. Because I'm God and God all by myself. And besides me, there is no other. Whatever you need, I got it. I'm Daddy God. I am God and I'm in charge. Woo, Jesus, I feel you pushing it down. Watch this. If you go to 22, he gives us encouragement. It's not only that. But just trust me. In the New Testament, says, I like this. He said, I urge you. Dear brothers and sisters, I encourage you, brothers and sisters, to pay attention to what I have just written in this brief exhortation. I like 22 because he says, what I've said to you in 21, I encourage you to pay attention to what I told you in 21 and don't let it go in one ear and out the other. Let it be maintained and sealed within your heart. I'm urging you. I'm exhorting you. I'm encouraging you to maintain. Watch this. I got three reference scriptures. They are on there. Listen to this. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 10 says this. He says, but may the God of all grace, who called us corporate, called us to his eternal glory, everlasting glory, Jesus, by Christ Jesus. Watch this. Did he give us some encouragement? Because you won't suffer.
Yes.
He says right here in his 10th verse, he said, you won't suffer.
Yeah.
But watch what he says. After you have suffered a while. Meaning that you're not going to always suffer.
All right.
Woo, Jesus. All right. In the future, you are not always go through what you went through in 2023. After you have suffered a little while. The suffering is not in vain, y'all. The suffering is not in vain. It's in the text. It's to make us. The suffering is to make us. I remember 2 weeks ago, Mr. Mary said in the Bible study, she said, we're going through these things to make us better. And I replied, I said, yeah, it was asked me, look at myself, stop crying so much because he's doing something in my suffering.
Yeah.
He's shaping me in my suffering.
Yes, he is.
He's doing something in my suffering. He's perfecting me in my suffering. He's establishing me in my suffering. He's healing me in my suffering. He's selling me in my suffering. He's doing something in my suffering. I got something just to be suffering, but I heard this, if we suffer him, we shall reign with him. Woo, Jesus. Which leads me to understand that if I'm going to suffer, I'm going to reign with him. If I suffer with him, I'm going to be with him in glory. Look at my suffering. It's all going to pay off after a while. Oh, suffering down here on these mundane shores is going to pay off after a while. Can I just go a little further? It's going to pay off right now.
That's right.
Oh, Jesus. I believe right now on these mundane shores, if we suffer a little while right here, we're going to benefit from it right here.
Yeah.
I don't have to wait for you to glory. Yeah, help me, y'all. Come on. I don't have to wait to glory for God to bless me. Because God can bless me right now. right now. Got your new right now. Got your cell right now. Got your perfect right now. God can move mighty for you right now. In the midst of what you're going through. In the midst of your headaches. In the midst of your misfortunes. In the midst of what you've been going through. God said, I can do it right now. In the present. Not so much in the future. Watch this. Philippians chapter 2, verse 13. He says this. You see him. He's rejected. For it is God. It is not a man. Not a woman.
Amen.
Not a boy or a girl. He says, for it is God who works in you both to will and do his good pleasure. It's God. Can I just throw something here? You and I have got to want God to work in us. Not myself, not yourself. It's God that works in us. Both to will and do his good pleasure. His good pleasure. I gotta say it again. His good pleasure. Meaning that God has got to be satisfied. And that God has got to do the work. It's not us doing the work, it's God that's got to work in us. For his glory and for his honor. It's God that does the work. We ought to ask God, God, work on me. Do the work on me. Do the work, God. Restore me. Restore. Restore means to make over. Make me over, God. I am flawed and I'm not perfect. But God, in the meantime, work on me. Make me over. You know, when the TV that said a total makeover? You do the home total makeover? Well, we need a spiritual total makeover. As we run into 2024, we need God to do a total makeover. Where we think. When we talk. When we act. When we feel. We got to have a total makeover. That God will be pleased. My last verse in reference. Hebrews 12 and 28 says this. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom which cannot be shaken. Kingdom. God's kingdom. And God's kingdom cannot be shaken. By no man. Let us have grace by which we may serve God. Watch this. That we may serve God acceptably. With reverence, respect. I want to pose a question to us. Do we really respect God? Do we really respect God? Lord's word reverence means respect. And he said, and godly fear. Hear me, because I'm asking myself a question. As I'm going to ask all this question. Do we really respect God? Because if we really, totally, wholeheartedly respect God, we wouldn't do some things he done. We wouldn't have said some things he said. Because when we say some things, it's in the presence of God. And literally in the presence of God. Your God is everywhere. Did the Bible say, the last time I checked, it says omnipresent. Meaning everywhere. He be in your kitchen. He be in your bathroom. He be wherever you are. And we say and do some stuff in God's presence. Do we really respect God? But if we really, 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 really respect God and really fear with reverence to God and godly fear, we would do some things we do and say some things we say. Because we're God watching. Watch this, thank you, Holy Ghost. Because you know when you were kids, you wouldn't do that in front of your parents. Okay, I got some witnesses. Because you know if you get something in their presence, you won't get in trouble. And so you would not do anything in their presence to be deserving of a whipping. You had such respect for your parents that you would not do anything wrong in their presence. Well, why in the world do we do the same thing in God's presence? And he's right there, and he's everywhere. Hear me, y'all, because God wants me to get this part right here clear. Why in the world do we stand there and do some crazy stuff in God's presence and don't respect God, but we respect our parents? God is more greater than my mother and my dad. And I ought to respect God more. Now, I still respect my mother. My dad's gone. I respect my mom, but I respect God more. Y'all hear what I said? I respect my mother highly, but guess what? I respect God more than I do my mother. Thank you. I am supposed to. Jesus said, I am supposed to. Check your phone with somebody. I am supposed to reverence him more than I am her. Because if I want to be blessed by God, I got to respect him more than I do my mother. According to biblical principles. Amen. As I close, we obey the Lord. Submit to his will and purpose. Rely on his Holy Spirit who dwells, who lives within us for everything we need. And please him, I give him honor and glory that he deserves. That's enough. I'm done. And he's cheating with me. Yes, and stand over the church, maybe someone desires prayer. If there's such persons who desire prayer, we come and we pray for you.
Wash me over again. Wash me over again. In your precious blood. Wash me over again. Wash me over. Wash me over again in your precious blood. Wash me over again. Wash me over again. Wash me over. In your precious blood, wash me over again.
We have this on our prayer list here. The Bryson family, the Lisa Williamson family, the youth, the nation of Israel, Sister Newbie, the traveling nurses, Diane Morgan, Tonight's grandson, Brother Russell and family, David Jr., and Elder Walker's daughter, Kim Mary. And we'll pray for them and these who come to the altar at this time. Most gracious and all-wise Father, we thank you.
for your goodness, your kindness, and your tender mercy, and all of your bountiful and wondrous blessings you have stored upon we, your people. You have and you are better as we are to ourselves, whereas I look glad about it. We thank you. You are everything. You are all in all. One said, you are El Shaddai, you are more than enough. We thank you, Lord. We need thanks and the praise, Lord. God, we can't do anything without you. We only move, we move and live through and by you. And we thank you for that, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that we're able to be in your house on the last day of the year. We thank you that you brought us this far. And we believe you will carry us into the new year, God. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you will shape us and mold us. Give us a greater desire. Give us greater hunger, greater thirst for you, God, in the coming year, God. Have us be better servants for you, God. We need your help. For we cannot do it of our own self, God. But God, we need your help. We need your strength to be better and do better. That you'll be pleased with our lives, God. Oh, God, bless us mightily. Bless us abundantly, God. Just strengthen us where we're weak and build us where we're torn down, God. I pray, God, you bless this brother who has come to the altar, God. You know where he stands in either, God. I pray you bless him mightily. Bless him abundantly, God. Move mightily for him, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God. Pray you bless the dying morning, God. Strengthen her, God. Shape and mold her, God. Bless her in a mighty and an abundant way, God. Bless her grandson, Darion, God. I pray you touch his life, touch his heart, touch his mind, God. Draw him to you, God, in the name of Jesus, we pray. Move by your mighty hand and move by your mighty power in his life, in the name of Jesus, we pray. And God, we pray, God, you bless the Bryson family, God, who lost a loved one, God. Give comfort, give strength, God. You reach where no one can reach, and you touch where no one can touch, God. Oh, God, I pray you bless the healed family, God. You, oh, God, you comfort, you reach where no one can reach, and you touch where no one can touch. God, you do as only you can do, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Not only those bereaved families, God, but bereaved families everywhere. Give comfort, give strength. You reach where no one can reach, and you touch where no one can touch. God, you do as only you can do, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God. We pray you bless the Larissa and family, God. Touch and bless them, God. Trinity, God. Move by your mighty hand, your mighty power for them, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God. Oh, God, I pray you bless our youth and young adults nationwide, God. Touch their hearts, touch their minds, God. Deliver them and set them free, God. In the name of Jesus, move by depression, move by oppression, God, and touch them, God, with your mighty hand, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Oh, God, I pray, God, you bless, God, the nation of Israel, God. Bring peace, God. This is your chosen people, God. Move by your mighty hand and move by your mighty power. Touch Israel, God, in the name of Jesus. And those who are held captive, God, I pray their protection and I pray their release will be soon in the name of Jesus. Oh God, move by your mighty hand and move by your mighty power. Do it, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. God bless the Shirley Newby, God. Give her tribe and mercy, God. Have her ride for destiny safely and bring her back home safely, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Oh, God, move by your mighty hand, mighty power from her, God. Bless Brother Russell and family, God. Oh, God, bless them, God. Strengthen them, God. Move mighty with them, God. Move in an awesome and mighty way, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God. Oh, God, I pray, God, you bless God. To the dignity son, David Jr., God. Move on David's behalf, God. Move for him, God, in a mighty and an awesome way, God, in the name of Jesus, God. Oh, God, but touch his heart and touch his mind, God, in the name of Jesus. Move, God. Oh, thank you, sir. Move by your mighty hand. Move by your mighty power in his life, God. Spiritually, God, in the name of Jesus. Do it, God. In the name of Jesus. God, I pray you bless Elder Walker's daughter, Kim Mary. God, touch her body with your mighty hand of healing, God. Move all for her, God. Oh, God, touch her from the top of her head to the sole of her feet, God. Touch and move, God, in the name of Jesus.
Oh, God, I pray, God, you bless all of our sick, God. Name by name and one by one, God. Touch and heal, God. Oh, God, and deliver, God, in the name of Jesus. God, I pray you bless the woman who prayed for your word tonight, God. Be with her. Speak to her. Speak to her, God. As she speaks with your people, God, give a fresh word, a clear word, God, a life-changing word, God. Help us, God, to come lift you up and magnify your name tonight, God. Oh, God, move by your mighty hand and your mighty power in the worship experience on tonight, God. Move awesome, God. Move mighty, God. In the name of Jesus, we pray, God. Oh, God, these blessings we ask in Jesus' mighty and awesome name we pray. And we do thank you. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God keep you this night. We ask to keep these persons in prayer. Yes.
With the saints of God, I didn't come up there because God has already heard y'all pray. And the reason, because now I know what's going on in this voice. Brother Jalen said that you get up and shout. God don't use me through a shout. He used me through my voice, and that's why the devil been trying. But now I know what's going on with this old boy. Yes. I've got 5 nodules on my thyroid. 5. Oh, Lord Jesus. My throat. But anyway, 5. I won't know what they're going to do until this week because of the holiday. But I do want to tell you all just to keep me on the list. It ain't ever been taken up.
No, it's not. That's too
late.
No, you're not.
No,
he's
healed.
No, he helped me. Oh God, in the name of Jesus, strengthen the word of even more, God.
You are El Rapha. You are the restored help, God. Restore, God. Her voice, God. Move by your mighty hand. Move by your mighty power. For something ever claim, God. In the name of Jesus. Do it for her, God. Thank you for what you've already done. Thank you for what you're doing right now. Thank you for what you're going to do. Give your name thanks. Give your name praise. Give your name honor. Give your name glory for what you're going to do for Sukhima. Thank you in advance. These blessings, we will be the God. Ask in Jesus' name for your glory and your Son, Jesus, we pray. And we thank you. Amen. Amen. God bless you. God keep you. God bless you. God bless you. Sister Betty, more good to see you.
Amen.
She looked good to see you. Brother Warren, good to see you. He works. But good to see you. Good to see you. See, to our visitors, we welcome you. I hope you enjoy yourself. Trust you enjoy yourself. God bless you. Good to see you, each and every one of you. God bless you. Let us stand with you. Yes, thank you. Hold on, say that for me, God. I'm sorry. Thank you for those lines. Okay, Father, we have get over back there. Let me give you the arrangements from Trustee Hill Funerals. It will be, the visitation will be Friday, which is January 5th. It will be from 9 to 10:30. The funeral will begin immediately at 10:30. And we will feed the family only. We'll feed the family only. And I'm seriously asking you, the church body, to pray for the family. I mean, really pray for the family. Lift them up before God. Please, ma'am, and please, sir. So those are the arrangements. Those are the arrangements. So we ask you to keep them in prayer. Remember that. It will be Friday, which is January 5th. Visitation 9 to 10:30, and the service will begin at 10:30 right here at the church. So pray for them. Amen. As you stand. Most gracious and all-wise Father, as we, your people, leave your house and go to our house, give us traveling mercies. Bind and mechanical problems. Dispatch your angels around about to not travel. We pray traveling mercies, God. Bless us mighty. Bless us, Maria. Bless us, God. We come back tonight to lift you up and magnify your name on this night, God. Bless the one who brings the word again, God. Be with us. Speak to him, God. Oh, God. Bless her mighty. Bless her mighty, God. Now to him is able to keep you from falling. Present you faultless before the presence of the only wise God, our Savior. Be glory, majesty, and dominion power, both now and forever. And the people of God's Son. Amen.